types of database management system softwares, and it depends, they are different. Why? Because they are storing the data differently, or you can say they are using a different underlying data structure. Okay, so here I'm representing what are the data structures which they are using, what are the data structures they are using, what are the database, what is the kind of database, and what is the DBMS called, or you can say what is the database management system is called. Okay, so you can say we have different types of data structures. Like if we have a hierarchical database, or you can say HIERARCHI. Okay, I am not good with spelling. So if you have hierarchical data structure, now for this hierarchical data structure, this is called as HDBMS or hierarchical database. Now the underlying data structures which we use are trees. Then so we have something called as network data structure, network DBMS. And this network DBMS is also called as NDBMS. And here we are going to use something called as graph as an underlying data structure. Then we have a relational database. It's also called as RDBMS. And underlying data structure is tables. Then we have object oriented database, and these are called as OODBMS, and this underlying data structure are objects. Then we have object relational databases, and these are also called as ORDBMS, and underlying data structure are objects as well as tables. Okay, now here in all these different types of databases, this hierarchical data structure and the hierarchical database management system and NDBMS, that is network database management system, these are now outdated. That means we don't use them anymore. Here in this subject, we are going to study something called as relational database management system. And this object database management system and relational database management system, these are relatively new as compared to the relational database management system, but they are not widely used in terms of applications, because widely used is the relational database management system. It is very easy to understand, very easy to grasp, as well as you can easily implement it. Okay, so in this case, there's something called as models in the database. That means a database can be divided into three types of models. Number one is, let me write it up. It is models in database management system. So you can study from the book. You can take either Korth. Let me tell you the books. Either you can take Korth or you can take Nawathe. Both the books are standard books for this subject. DBMS, Introduction to Database Management System, and both the books are standard books for this subject. You can follow any one of these books. Both of them are really good. So I'll prefer that if you will be having both the books, then it will be better. Okay. So number one is models in the database. So the database can be divided into three models. Number one is the high level model, or it is also called as conceptual model. Then we have something called as the representational or implementational model. Or you can say it is the underlying layer, that is representation layer or implementational layer. And the third one is called as the logical level or physical data model. The logical level or physical data model. Okay, so this deals with when I'm saying we have these models, that means I'm telling you that in what things these levels are working on. For example, when we have high level or conceptual model, that means in this model we generally discuss about the ER model, or you can say ER diagrams, right? Or you can say entity relational diagrams. when we say representational or implementational model, that means we are mostly going to discuss about the relations. And when we are saying that we are going to discuss about the logical level or the physical level, that means we are going to discuss about how or what is the actual physical storage of that data. What is the actual physical storage of the data, or you can say actually how the database is stored in the memory. Okay, or you can say what is the underlying data structure which we are using. Now, I'm not going to discuss about all these three models right now in complete detail. I'm just giving you the terminologies here, just a slight introduction to the terminologies, because as we go on with the subject, we are going to discuss about these terminologies in complete depth. In the end, again, I'm going to give you a complete introduction, or you can say complete brief about what we studied in the entire subject, because we are going to start with the ER model, then we'll slowly make a transition to the relations and relational model, relational algebra. And then we'll slowly make a transition toward the physical model. After studying all these models in the complete details, you can say the complete subject is divided into these three specific models. After studying all the subject with the complete details, we'll come back to this specific topic, and then we'll try to explain them one by one, because I believe that after studying them in detail, it will be very easy for you to, you know, remember or grasp what these models actually are. Because right now I want you to start with as minimum terminologies as possible, because that is going to create very less, you know, burden on your headache. Because if I'm going to just give you a lot of information right now, then this is going to give you, you know, it will be very difficult for you to cover throughout the subject with that, and it will be kind of giving you headaches for remembering the terminologies. So I want to start with the very minimum terminologies or details with you, so that thoroughly we'll build up the concept, and thoroughly slowly we are going to cover everything in detail. Okay.